Hello and welcome back to this channel. So today's video is going to be about color themes. Now you have created an illustration and you have picked out all the colors by manually selecting them, you know, using the color wheel and stuff like that. And now you want to save this into your library. That is, if you go to Window and then Libraries. And if you want to save it here, how do you do that? So this video is all about color themes. That is, we're going to learn how to save your colors into your library. Also, find out different themes based on your favorite color theme. So let's just get started. You have opened your library. Now it's time to open your color themes. Go to Window and then Color Themes. All right, so first we're going to try and save this to either our Swatches or to Library. So let's go ahead, and as you open this, you'll see this particular window. This might be different for you guys, obviously. And then you'll see three things: Create, Explore, and My Themes. So if you click on My Themes, this is where you'll see all the color themes that you have saved. Obviously, there are different libraries here, and you can select whichever you want. And right now, I'm just going to keep it in my library, and I have 168 themes in there. So, okay. The next is the Explore tab. This connects to your Creative Cloud account, and therefore, all your Creative Cloud themes can be seen here. You can sort it out by most popular or anything. These are not in your library yet, so you'll have to select these three dots, click, and say either add to Swatches, or you can edit this theme and then add it to your library. You can also favorite it and then go ahead and add it to your library as well. Now to create. So this is where you first of all create your color themes. So now I'm just going to click on this one. Let's ignore the triangles right now because we're going to deal with that later. And there are options here. So here it says click to set active color. So what this means is I have this tree and I want to click on this and I want it to be this color. As you can see, you cannot use the eyedropper tool as such. So we'll have to use this button which says click to set active color. And then automatically sets that color to that particular object. So I'm just going to undo that. And next up is set selected color from active color. So if you want this color to be this one, just click on this and it's going to set this color over there. So as you can see, this automatically changed to, you know, a different color theme. That's mainly because if you come here, there's something called as color rule. And we'll dive into color rule later. But if you click on this, you can click on custom. And now you can edit it to your particular color theme. So let's go ahead and click on the next color and choose it as, you know, whatever color we want. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on this one. And I want this to be the first color. And this would be the second. So this is an arbitrary choice of colors. Because I already have it in my theme and I've planned this class around this color theme in this particular order. But you can go ahead and select any tile you want and choose and give any color you want. There's no particular way in which you have to give these colors. At least according to me, you can just give it whatever you want. Alright, so we have our color theme set and now it's time to add it to our swatches. So to access swatches, you can go to Window and then Swatches. So adding to swatches is kind of temporary. Sometimes it might not carry on from one file to another. So the best way to make sure your themes are available for you everywhere, even across Photoshop, etc., is to add it to your library. But let's just assume we want it for this particular task or for this artwork, and then we're going to add it to the swatches. So you just go ahead and click on this add to swatches, and then it automatically comes up here. So this is how you add it to swatches. But if you want a more permanent one, what you can do is you can add this to your theme. And I'm just going to change the theme here as tutorial. So let's go ahead and click on save. And now it asks you a question like where you want to add this to. Because I have multiple libraries created, so it gives me this option. And it probably gives you this option even if you have one library created. Just click on save. And now this should reflect in your library that you have chosen. I have this My Library, that's the one, and if you look at that, the most, it'll be on the top of your color themes and you can see it here. And that's basically how you add colors to your color theme. And next up is, what if I find a really good color theme in actually the Explore button? I want to edit it. So you just have to go ahead and pick some color theme that you like. Let's just say I like this one. Just click on the three dots, click on Edit this theme. And now you like this one. So I'm just going to go ahead and change this one to this color just because I can. Okay, I like that. And this yellow, I'll switch it up with this one. Okay, and now we'll add it to a color theme. So it says copy of, this was the original theme. That's fine. Let's just click on save. And yes, let's go ahead and check this. Okay, so we have our color theme here, and that's perfect. All right, so that's it for adding color themes to your library. And now let's go ahead and do the next important thing, that is, let's learn a little bit about the color rule. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to my themes, and I'm going to pick up my theme which I saved a few minutes ago. Click on edit this theme. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the color rule here. Right now it's in custom, obviously. So we're going to try and switch it up or try different things over here. And I will not assure you that everything will look great, but for some things, some color schemes look great. For some, it just doesn't look great. Okay, so the color rule. I've made this illustration in different color rules. Okay, so one thing you have to notice here is I've not arranged the color in a way so that they'll look good, because that's one thing you'll have to do even if you use these different forms of color rule in your artwork. But the whole reason I did this was I just wanted to show like what happens to this green, like in this place, when it switches over to this color. You'll understand what I'm trying to explain. So first of all, let's change the base. So these color rules depend on the base color. So in this, yellow is set as a base color, and you can see this white triangle. Now if you want to set red as the base color, you just have to click here and say set as base color. Now everything that you do will take red as the base color and change all other colors respective to that. That means the red is going to be constant everywhere. Okay, so let's go ahead and take analogous. So I'm not somebody who's an expert in color rules, so I'm not going to explain so much when it comes to this, but I just want to show you different things when it happens and how the illustration changes when you have different color rules to them. So you can see there's so many different rules, and this one looks perfect, but it might not be the same for everything else as well. But sometimes some color themes are much better when they follow one of these color rules. For example, this one, this is a beautiful color theme. And if you look at that, it's this one right here. It's actually a pretty good color theme, which would look very amazing on illustrations. And if you know how to, like, you know, just mix and match them and see which colors suit which color. Maybe the roof could be brown, and maybe instead of the tree being brown, we could probably keep it like something like pink. And you should click on set to active color. So this kind of sets it. So it's something like this. Maybe this would look better. I will just put it back. So yeah, you have to make that judgment. And then is triad. Triad is basically 3 points forming a triangle like this on the color wheel, and that gives you this particular unique color piece, which is like usually bright and colorful and very nice. And I usually like triad color scheme, and I use it a lot as well, but in this case it's not looking really good. But you can switch it up like I told, and probably make this as yellow and this as blue, because then it kind of makes more sense. Let's just put it back. And next up is complementary. Complementary colors are nothing but which are on the extreme end of the color scheme. So if you move this around, the complementary colors come down over here. So it's like yellow and blue are like perfect combination. Like you can look at this here. It looks really good. Compound. So it just takes some colors. Yeah, I don't use compound very much in my illustrations, but sometimes they look good too. Okay, and next up is shades. Shades is nothing but you pick a color and it's like different shades of the same color, and it looks really good sometimes. I really like shades most of the time, and I use it a lot as well. So once you have this, and if you like this color theme, so that's what we are talking about. So if you like this color theme, you can just click here and change the name of whatever you want and click on save, and then it'll reflect in your library. So this library saves itself, so it's like on cloud, so you can access it across all your other Adobe platforms, especially in Photoshop. I haven't tried on other things, but Photoshop, definitely you can access this library and colors, and it's a very good thing. Okay, so one thing we haven't talked about is sliders. So you can use these sliders to change the colors to match however you want. This is pretty cool as well, but unfortunately I don't use it as much. But like you can see, you can get different options here as well, and there's RGB and other things as well over here. So yeah, I've told you how to get color themes from the internet, discussed about how to access your themes from here, and how to edit these things to modify them to suit your needs. And that's all about color themes actually. So go ahead and make some beautiful color themes, and you can share them. So do that as well, because it's because of these people out there who share their color themes that we have access to such beautiful color themes. Okay, thanks for watching, and that brings us to the end of this video. Let's create something new again next week. Bye.